In November, at the annual shareholders meeting, the board made Buccaneer shareholders aware of our expectation that in 2010, there would be a number of excellent acquisition opportunities that would present themselves. We're here today to talk to you about one of those opportunities, the first of a number that we have looked at. Buccaneer has concluded a definitive purchase agreement with Stellar Oil and Gas to acquire Stellar's Alaska oil and gas position, lease position, and personnel. This is a major acquisition for Buccaneer and dramatically impacts both our potential reserve base and our leasehold position. In fact, the acquisition of Stellar's properties in Alaska gives Buccaneer a lease position in Alaska alone of over 52,000 acres with P10 reserves exceeding 1.2 TCF of gas and 149 million barrels of oil. Stated in terms of most likely or P50 reserves, the numbers are still significant. They would amount to 598 Bcf of gas and 53 million barrels of oil. Obviously, by any measure, these are major impact reserves for Buccaneer and represent only the initial activity for Buccaneer in Alaska. One might ask, why Alaska? Why this step for Buccaneer strategically? There are a number of compelling reasons, not the least of which is that Alaska has enacted a number of tax programs that effectively make it possible for a company like Buccaneer to get substantial tax incentives from the government to do drilling and development work. This can amount to as much as 65 cents in return funds for every dollar that Buccaneer would spend on a development. Additionally, we like Alaska because of the low-risk nature of the kinds of reserves we're targeting. We have always had a program where we were offsetting known reserves, looking for stacked pays with large deposits of hydrocarbons that have historically been present in a region. Alaska fits all of these requirements and represents a very substantial upside opportunity for Buccaneer with very limited risk. We believe, based on the due diligence that we've conducted thus far, that with proper activity levels over the next few months, that we can realize a goal of having drilling operations commence in Alaska during the 2010 calendar year. As I've said, not only are the reserves impact reserves, but this is but the first of a number of opportunities that we're looking at to dramatically increase Buccaneer's size and footprint in the oil and gas world. I would like to introduce Gary Reinhart, Buccaneer's exploration officer, to give you more details about this exciting new opportunity for the company.
Thank you, Curtis. We're going to look in a little more detail of what Curtis has already described to you as an acquisition in Alaska. Specifically, the leases that we're acquiring in Alaska are in the Cook Inlet Basin of Alaska. This is the oldest producing, oil-producing area in Alaska. And we specifically want to look at three of the opportunities that we have acquired with Stellar Oil and Gas. The first one that we'll talk about is right off the North Cook Inlet field. It is called our Northwest Cook Inlet Prospect. The P50 reserves here are in excess of 380 BCF and 35 million barrels of oil. The second one would be down a bit further to the south, also offshore, and that is the North Middle Ground Shoal lease. That lease is attempting to extend the Middle Ground Shoal field to the north and is drilling on the same structure. Middle Ground Shoal has produced almost 200 million barrels of oil and a significant amount of gas. Prospect at North Middle Ground Shoal is actually offsetting an older well drilled in the 60s, I believe, as I recall, which actually tested over 3 million cubic feet of gas from one zone. Okay, now we're going to talk about the onshore portion of this acquisition. These acres that are onshore are on the Kenai Peninsula. They're on the southern end of the peninsula. And in fact, they're southeast of the acreage that we've just talked about that was on offshore. The Kenai Peninsula acreage has a couple of wells that were drilled there in the mid-60s, and that they actually appear to have oil and gas in them. Unfortunately, being those older logs and not having the porosity information, we do not know for sure, but it appears very promising. We have P50 reserves here in excess of 100 BCF and 10 million barrels of oil. That's why Buccaneer is very excited about Alaska.